Go Vikes! What's up, everybody? Welcome to another edition of Viking Spin. I'm your host, Jason, and we're going to break down the Vikings-Redskins post-game. The Vikings get a win here, 38-30, in Washington, D.C., over the Redskins. The Vikings improve to 7-2 on the season, still sitting atop the NFC North in first place. And the Redskins drop to 4-5. On the season. Today, Case Keenum had a career-high 4 touchdown passes today. An absolutely amazing game by him, 304 pass yards. And he distributed that. Adam Thielen caught 8 passes for 166 yards and a touchdown. Stephon Diggs had 5 catches for 78 yards and a touchdown. And also David Morgan and Jarius Wright caught touchdown passes today as well. In a running game, Latavius Murray and Jerick McKinnon combined for 100 yards on the ground. And Latavius Murray also had a touchdown. The offensive line was excellent today. There were no sacks given up. Case Keenum was not sacked even one time. 100 yards on the ground. Over 300 yards passing, so I can't say enough about the offensive line this season and what a difference they've made for the Vikings. And I think that's the biggest difference between the Vikings this season and last season is the play of the offensive line. It's just night and day. The defense today, they made some plays when they were needed. I mean, not their best game, but to be fair, they're playing without Everson Griffin, who should be able to return next week against the Rams. But, some guys came up with plays at key moments. Danielle Hunter had a big sack in the fourth quarter to force a field goal attempt instead of Washington, being able to get a touchdown. Mackenzie Alexander had an interception in the second quarter, which led to a Vikings touchdown. Late in the first half. He also had a nice pass breakup to stop what would have been a touchdown. Andrew Sandejo had a couple of nice pass breakups. And Harrison Smith was just all over the field today, making plays. And I thought also Anthony Barr did a good job on Washington running back Chris Thompson, holding him in check for the most part. One of the themes today was the Vikings were clutch all day, and Kai Forbath, I mean, he was really clutch in the fourth quarter with his field goal. He hit it from 53 yards out. He's 5 for 5 on the season for on field goals from 50 out. Now I think he's hit 16 in a row overall, and that made it 38-27. So it was actually 35-27. The Vikings had an 8-point lead in the fourth quarter. So, if they miss that one, then Washington gets the ball back in a 1-score game. But Forbath made it a 2-score game. Bang it from 53 yards out. The Vikings go up 11. And, it's a different ball game. So, the Vikings, I thought, were clutch all day. Even when they had faltered, Keenum had a couple interceptions there in the second half. But in the fourth quarter after the last one there, I was impressed with how he stayed mentally tough. He was able to bounce back from the mistakes, and he led the Vikings on that field goal drive that Forbath connected on the 53-yarder. So, Keenum definitely, and he started off red hot, and then he was also able to bounce back from some adversity to finish strong. So overall today, a great team win for the Vikings. Now, like I said, 7-2 on the season. They'll be going up and going back to Minnesota, U.S. Bank Stadium, to face the Rams on our home turf. So I do have to give a shout out though today to the Vikings fans that went down to Washington, D.C. And the Vikings players even remarked after the game that they were able to hear the skull chants. So the Vikings definitely, the fans travel well I will say. I'm personally excited to be going to the next game in Minnesota when we play the Rams. I will be there. Can't wait to see it. The Vikings are right here in the thick of the NFC playoff race, and I think it's going to be a great matchup against the Rams, and we'll of course have coverage of that in a Vikings-Rams preview podcast this week. And I thank you guys so much for tuning in again to another edition of Viking Spin, and I'll leave you with a little Goldfinger, 99 Red Balloons.
All right.